Good morning. I hope you're doing well and happy Mother's Day. I figured I would get in my morning live right before it turns to PM. It's Mother's Day, so I'm getting kind of a slow start this morning. Anyways, as promised, I wanted to talk to you guys about forgiveness to get today and practicing forgiveness and how to include that in your life. And there's a couple things I'm going to talk about, but the first thing I want to really think about or talk about is I often hear from people, why should I forgive someone for hurting me? And isn't that just letting them off the hook? And the answer is no, it's actually not. By practicing forgiveness, you can come to peace and find closure from the hurt that you've been feeling that otherwise you wouldn't be able to find. So it's a really, really important practice for yourself opposed to giving something to somebody else. So the thing I want you to think about is that continuing to feel angry towards someone else, it may bother them, but odds are it probably won't. The reality is if they hurt you in the past, they probably don't really care that much about how you're feeling now. That's not a focus for them. So feeling angry towards them, all it's really doing is prolonging your hurt and your unhappy feelings. So forgiving them doesn't have to let them off the hook. What it can actually do is let you say, what you did wasn't okay, but I'm gonna move on from that situation so I no longer feel pain. Forgiveness is simply the practice of letting go, of making peace with what happened, and moving forward with your life. That's really what forgiveness is. You don't even have to tell the person that hurt you that you're forgiving them. They don't ever have to know that you've forgiven them. But you need to do it for your own well-being and your own mental sanity. So, as always, I'm going to give you a little practice tool or homework to do for yourself. So, a couple days ago, I asked you to get a journal to write about gratitude. And I want you to get out the same journal and write down some of the things that you still feel anger about towards somebody else that's hurt you. I want you to get really, really deep into this. Write down all of the details, write all the little nitty-gritty stuff, get it out in the notebook. Keep in mind, you're the only one that's going to see this notebook, so you don't have to worry about what you write, but get those feelings out onto a piece of paper. Really, really be detailed here. Spend some time doing it. Write everything out. Once you've done that, decide to draw a line in the sand and say, today is the day that I'm going to let this go and move forward. The reason I want you to be so detailed about all of this is that I want you to physically get it out of you and get it onto the piece of paper, into the notebook. Get all that anger and hurt and feelings onto the notebook so that it's no longer resonating inside of you. Decide that today is going to be the day that you're going to move forward with the forgiveness and move forward with letting go of the hurt and pain. And then close the journal. Just let it go. Set it somewhere. Don't think about it. Don't look back at those pages. Give yourself a little time. And then write down one thing that you're grateful for after you've let that set in about this practice, about letting go of this anger or hurt. Write down the gratitude that you feel about not having those feelings inside of you anymore. If you can do this in a regular practice when somebody's hurt you or made you feel angry, it'll help you start to identify one, the triggers that are causing you to feel uneasy or give you anxiety or feel unhappy. It might help you identify people that are unhealthy in your life, and so you can change those relationships, or if it comes to that point, remove that person from your life. And it'll help you relieve the anxiety, relieve the anger, and relieve the stress in a much quicker way so that you can bounce back from these negative situations that are inevitably going to occur in your life. I hope this helps you. I hope you find it a good practice. Tomorrow, we're going to talk about choosing kindness. So I hope you will join me back here tomorrow. And as always, I'm here for you. So if I can help in any way, please don't hesitate to reach out. I love you lots, and I'm super grateful for your time. I hope you have a wonderful Mother's Day. Give all your moms hugs and kisses because they are the unsung heroes. And just hope you have a good day. Love you. Bye.